Okay, so today I'd like to talk a little bit about Elmwood. I'm not a great teacher and I don't claim to be an expert, but I work with wood day in and day out as I'm being a sawyer, and I learned a few things, so why not to share the information I know. It is quite hard to come by Elmwood nowadays. I would say almost count as a rare species because of the Dutch elm disease in the 70s. Majority of the elm population died out. They are fairly good outdoor wood. They tend to resist rotting fairly well, unless they come into contact with ground. If you're gonna dig this down as a post, it will rot on ground level. In terms of workability, they are fairly good. But if you plane it, if you want to put it through your thicknesser, you got to be careful because they have a tendency to tear out, and then you can sand it forever to make the surface, you know, smooth enough and decent enough. I think I'm just gonna start working on one of these, and I'll switch to voiceover. So I'd like to talk a little bit more about the Dutch elm disease. I believe that has been identified first in the 1930s and 40s in the USA. So that disease is basically a fungi carried by bark boring beetles. They carry this fungi on their bodies, and in their bodies they dug themselves into the bark of the tree, lay like egg colonies, and spread the fungi from tree to tree, and that's how they die basically. So there are several different species of elm out there. The two main groups are hard elms and soft elms. In the wood database.com I find like 8 species mentioned. Hard elms contain like winged elms, cedar elm, and rock elm. In the soft elm species, American elm, witch elm, and English elm, red elm, and Dutch elm. But on other sites I've seen way more elm species mentioned. I think like at least 18 different species or maybe more. Contained like Siberian elm and Himalayan elm, and you know, the list goes on and on. It has interlocking grain, and that makes it very resistant to splitting. That's why I mentioned before that I don't even seal the end grain. It's also very flexible, and for that reason it was, as far as I'm concerned, the second most preferred wood after English yew for making longbows. It is certainly good for furniture making. It glues, stains, and finishes really well. I'm not too sure about the food safety aspect of it. But I would say probably is not really ideal for making chopping boards and stuff like that, based on the fact that most of these trees has been cut down because of Dutch elm disease, and they were dying or already dead, very likely be fungi infected already. And I wouldn't really want to make chopping boards out of it or want to eat anything from a chopping board which has fungi infection in it. When elm wood is fresh cut, it has quite strong unpleasant smell, but it goes away as it dries. And it dries fairly quick due to the open fibered grain structure. If I grab a piece which let's say have 25% moisture content and I put it in my living room, it usually dries out in only a few weeks. It will drop down below 12% moisture content. I don't like dry data very much, but I just like to mention a few facts about the trees itself. So English elm, for example, can reach the height of 80 to 115 feet, which is 25 to 35 meters tall. And the diameter across can be 3 to 6 feet or 1 to 2 meters, technically. But I don't think they actually do that nowadays, since they die prematurely due to the Dutch elm disease. The dried weight for English elm is around 35 lbs per cubic feet or 565 kg per cubic meter. And the Genka hardness is 810. And by the way, I'm reading this to you because I wouldn't really know that sort of information from the top of my head. It just doesn't interest me very much. I'm pretty sure there are people out there who knows way more about elmwood or wood species in general than I do. If you think I left something out from this video which is worth mentioning, please go to the comment section and leave your information there so everyone can read it. Or if you think some of my information was incorrect, please let me know, I'd like to hear about it. And finally, I'd like to mention, if you happen to be a UK woodworker looking for elmwood for your current woodworking project, I will have some available in my eBay store. I'm not too sure for how long because I have limited stock. If you happen to watch this video in the future, it might be too late. But there will be always something cool listed in my eBay store, so no worries. And finally, I just wanted to show you a test piece of elmwood, which you can see me working on right now. It is always cool to see how the grain pops when you apply oil to the surface. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you liked it, and thank you very much for watching.